Christmas men won't be boys, playing with bombs like kids play with toys. One warm December, our hearts will see a world.
Hello everyone and welcome back to Ms.Cheryl's Place. Today's video is a DIY challenge video that is hosted by Bobby Cats Kitten. If you would like to see what it is that I came up with for her DIY challenge, stay tuned. Alright guys, the title of her collaboration or her challenge is Home for the Holidays DIY. That's right, it's a holiday DIY challenge. And she has issued this challenge and said that it's pretty much up to the creator to do whatever they want to do, however they want to do it. So, I came up with something and I can't wait for you guys to see what it is. Stay tuned. Alright everyone, so here I am getting ready to take the Dollar Tree scarf, the Buffalo Check one, that I purchased at Dollar Tree along with a Dollar Tree ball. And I'm going to tie the scarf around the ball. I could have glued it on, but I chose to tie it and I thought this would come out better. And I like the way that I did it. Now on that part right there, I'm going to eventually use some hot glue to make sure that that stays covered, because it just was not an even scarf to be able to wrap it around the ball. So that's the reason why I tied it. It made a whole lot more sense to tie it. And as you see, what I'm doing is making sure that all of the green is covered. And once I do that, I was thinking, okay, I use a zip tie, maybe a rubber band or something on the lines that would keep it sealed. And instead, as you see, I decided that I would just tie the top as well as I did the bottom. As you see, I have a zip tie, but I just didn't like the idea of the zip tie. I think tying it turned out much better because it gave me the look I was going for, versus using the zip tie to seal to keep it together. So I double knot tied it. I thought that came out a whole lot better. Now what I'm doing now is I'm trying to decide how I'm going to decorate it. I have an idea in my head, and of course I'm in my supplies that I have on the side of me, trying to decide on which way I'm going to go. So I took some of the garland wrap from the Dollar Tree and decided that I would anchor it on top. And you'll see what I'm doing it with after I do that. I thought this made it look pretty different. I was not trying to go with what I've seen other people do. I was doing something that was original to me. And I absolutely love the way it turned out in the end. And I hope you will too. So I'm hot gluing that. To the top, carefully using my scissors because I've gotten burnt a couple of times using some hot glue, and recently I have, so doing everything in my power to avoid touching that hot glue because it really will burn you, especially since I have a high powered hot glue gun. And then I'm going to go ahead and glue the other side to that. Careful to use my scissors because I don't want my hand to touch that hot glue. I'm also sitting here thinking, should I keep it on the end because that would make it more different? But then I decided that I might cut it, but I still kept it on. As you see, I'm thinking in my head which way to go. But I cut these berries off because I knew I was going to use the berries. I took some of that cotton, the cotton balls as well, and a couple of pine cones, and a branch. I just took a few pieces off of this bush, off of this pick, actually, that I purchased from Walmart. I wasn't quite sure how I was going to use them. I just clipped them because I seen them and I thought to myself what I could do with them. But I wasn't too sure how I was going to end up using them. So here I am, as you see, I'm trying to figure out which way I'm going to go with it once I get it clipped off. And I'm thinking in my head, which way can I go? What can I do with it? And how can I adorn this ornament that I'm going to make here? There was some plastic on here. It was pretty hard to get it off, and I fought with it till I finally got it loose. You see, I'm struggling with it. I didn't end up using that at all. I didn't even bother to use that. I thought, okay, I could hang the berries off. Here I'm counting the berries. I thought I could hang them off, and then I thought, you know what? Let me cut them off. So that's what I'm doing here. And then I'm thinking, how could I put it on here? So then I decided I'm going to use this cotton to be my centerpiece to work around it. And then that was also hard to take apart. I struggled getting that off of the stem. Once I get it cut down to size, I will hot glue it again. I'm fiddling it around with that, thinking, what can I do with it? And then, as you see, like I said, I'm just moving things around, trying to figure it all out. Thinking I would add that, and then, like I said, I never even used that pick. So I decided, okay, let me throw a pine cone in here. Change my mind about the cotton ball and use the pine cone as the center. Then I followed up with the cotton ball. So at this point, I'm going to allow Stevie Wonder to continue singing Someday at Christmas. I absolutely love that song. Which one is y'all's favorite Christmas song? I have a few. Otis Redding, Merry Christmas, Baby. I also love Stevie Wonder's Someday at Christmas. I also love Gee Whiz, It's Christmas. I forgot which group sings that. It's an olden group. Love Donny Hathaway's and Chris Brown's version of Donny Hathaway's This Christmas. Absolutely love that song. I bow out all kinds of Christmas music. So basically, I have a very serious Christmas playlist. Anything to have to do with the R&B soul Christmas music. So what is you guys' favorite Christmas songs? Put it down in the comments below. Let me know what you like to listen to during this holiday season. And I'm going to end it at this point and let you guys listen to the smooth sounds of Stevie Wonder's Christmas song, Someday at Christmas. A world where men are free. Someday at Christmas, there'll be no wars when we have learned what Christmas is for. Alright everyone, so here's the finished product of the ornament that I just showed you guys. I've been making it. I lost the rest of the footage to show you the rest of how it ended. So I'm going to take it off the tree so you can see it all the way around. It's a great accessory to go with the rest of my tree. I'd like to thank you guys for watching my video. And I would like to thank Bobby Cats Kitten
for hosting this DIY collaboration. I really appreciate the open invite and thank you very much for doing so. If you have not subscribed to my channel, please feel free to hit the subscribe button and like, comment, and share. This is not the end. This is, see you in the next video.